Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the online video classes in biology. Today, we will start the new chapter, chapter number 10, microbes in human welfare. As far as microbes are concerned, what do you mean by this? Microorganism or microbes are the very fine organisms which cannot be seen without the help of microscope. They may exist in the form of single cell or it may be found in the form of colonies. So, dear students, microbes are also known as invisible masters of the world. There are different types of microbes further classified, out of which the first microbe is bacteria. This is the group of unicellular prokaryotes. Another microbes may be fungi, unicellular eukaryotes, which are known as protists, and many other microorganisms may be found in the nature. Every microorganism has its own work, has its own function in the environment, and it regulates the ecosystem. So, dear students, in this chapter, microbes and human welfare, you can see a microorganism or a microbe is a microscopic organism which may exist in its single celled form or a colony of cells. So you can see microbes found either in the form of single cell or it may be found in the form of groups, and this group of microbe is known as colony. So types of microorganisms you can see in the yellow color, these are the bacteria, this is fungi, protist, single-celled eukaryotes, and viruses. Although viruses are the connecting link of living and non-living things. This is the figure number 10.1 given in the book. These are the rod-shaped bacteria. These are the spherical bacteria, which is known as cocci. And this is the rod-shaped bacteria that has flagella on the surface of the bacteria. These are the viruses. You can see the figure 10.2. A bacteriophage virus is given here that infects the bacteria. B is the example of adenovirus that causes respiratory infections. And the C is the rod-shaped Tobacco mosaic virus, magnified almost 100 to 150,000 x in electron microscope. This is the another figure is given, colonies of bacteria growing in the petri plate, and this is the fungal colony grown in the petri plate on a specific culture medium. Now we will start the use of microbes. It has different areas of uses, out of which the first is microbes in household products. There are many microbes which are used to prepare different types of food items, out of which very first one is curd formation. Microorganisms such as lactobacillus and others commonly called lactic acid bacteria, LAB, grow in a milk and convert it to curd. So these are the bacteria that will help in the curd formation. Lactic acid bacteria produce acids that coagulate and partially digest the milk proteins. It also improves its nutritional quality by increasing vitamin B12. So curd is vitamin B12 rich. In our stomach too, the lab play very beneficial role in checking disease causing microbes. So another one more important thing, that curd is more beneficial food than the milk because it contains vitamin B12 and its protein is semi-digested. This is the outline for diagram of the curd formation. Initially, milk is incubated with curd. Growth of lactic acid bacteria seen. Product of X. Improved nutritional quality due to increased Y. Here you can see the production of X, where X is the lactic acid and where nutritional quality due to increased Y. What is the Y here? Vitamin B12 and coagulation and digestion of milk protein can be seen. The second product used in our houses are, it may be idli, dosa and bakery industry. How can we prepare the idli, dosa and bakery products? The dosa and idli is also fermented by bacteria. And the dough which is used for making bread is fermented using baker's yeast. And the scientific name of baker's yeast is Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Here you can see the figure, prepare a variety of bakery products. And bakery products must contain following characteristics: crisp crust, soft eating, moist, its color is also important, consistency and texture is important, visual appeal is important, mouth feel and eating qualities must be better for a bakery product. In the third, traditional drinks. A number of traditional drinks and foods are also made by fermentation by the microbes. Toddy, it is also known as toddy, a traditional drink of some parts of the southern India, is made by fermenting sap of the palm plants. And basically it is an alcoholic drink which is used in the coastal areas. How will you prepare the toddy? So first of all, there is a palm tree, just cut 10 to 15 centimeters from top of the trunk, tapping a guard is fixed below the cut, collection of the sap each day. Every day it may give almost 70 liters to 100 liter, and this collected sap is known as neera. This neera can be freshly used. This is the drink fresh, and you can use it by fermentation. Natural fermentation occurs as soon as the sap is collected. Now we need to filter it. This is optional. You can use it without filtration. And this product is known as toddy. And this toddy can be bottled in the bottles also. Other products in the household is, microbes are also used to ferment fish. We can ferment the fish, soya bean, bamboo shoots to make foods. Cheese is one of the oldest food items in which microbes were used. The large holes in Swiss cheese are due to production of a large amount of CO2 by bacterium named Propionibacterium charmani. So this is the softened cheese, because large amount of CO2 will help in the formation of large holes. The another cheese is the Roquefort cheese. It is ripened by growing a specific fungus on them. So its ripening is done by using the fungi, which gives them particular flavor. So Roquefort cheese is famous for its specified flavor. This is the outline of cheese formation. You can see milk, as normal milk contains protein, fat, lactose, sugar and minerals. We can use the natural sourcing of starter culture, or we can use the coagulant just like Calotropis procera or as calcium chloride. If we will add Calotropis procera latex or calcium chloride, then coagulation will be done. Now soft curd is obtained. We will remove the whey from this. Now firm curd is obtained. Molding is required and final cheese product is prepared. This figure is showing the different types of cheese in the world. This is brie, Camembert cheese, ricotta, Neufchâtel, feta, cheddar, gorgonzola, quark, Danish blue, mozzarella, parmesan, cottage cheese, asiago, queso blanco, grana padano, stilton, cream cheese, appendezeller, raclette, and roquefort. So you can see the figure of the different types of cheeses found in the world. It is very delicious and very well known ancient product in the world. Now we will start the second application of the microbes in industrial products. Different types of industrial products are also prepared by using the microbes. In industry, microbes are used to synthesize a number of products valuable to human beings. Beverages and antibiotics are some examples. Production of an industrial scale requires growing microbe in a very large vessel called fermenter. So fermenter is required for the growth of microbes. And we have already discussed about the fermenter, or another name is bioreactor in the biotechnology. The first is fermented beverages. Microbes like yeast are used for the production of beverages like wine, beer, whiskey, brandy, rum, etc. All these are the fermented beverages. The same yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, used for bread making and commonly called brewer's yeast. So we will use the Saccharomyces cerevisiae here. This is the common brewer's yeast. It will ferment malted cereals and fruit juices to produce ethanol. So ethanol is prepared by using the cereals and fruit juices. Wine and beer are produced without distillation. So this is the basic difference. If question is asked, what is the difference between wine and beer and whiskey, brandy and rum? So wine and beer are produced without distillation. Distillation process is absent in the preparation of wine and beer, while the distillation process is present in whiskey, brandy and rum. This is the classification of beverages here. Beverages are further subdivided in two parts, non-alcoholic and alcoholic. Non-alcoholic, it means that does not contain alcohol. Non-carbonated, it means it will not possess the carbon dioxide. Fruit juices, fruit drinks, fruit nectars, coffee and tea. And carbonated drinks are soda, Coca-Cola, tonic water, Pepsi, Limca, Mirinda and many more. Alcoholic drinks, these are the fruit sap or grain. Fruit may be non-distilled like wine and distilled like brandy. So we can prepare the wine and brandy with the help of fruit saps. While on the other hand, beer and whiskey is made by using the grains like barley and maize and other cereals also. So this was the fermented drinks like wine, beer, whiskey, brandy and rum. The second most important product of the microbe in the industry is antibiotics. First of all, what do you mean by the antibiotic? So an antibiotic is a type of antimicrobial substance. Basically, it is an antimicrobial substance specifically active against bacteria. So what is antibiotic? Then the definition is, it is an antimicrobial substance that kills the bacteria, or that is used to stop the growth of bacteria. You can see this is the founder of the antibiotics, Sir Alexander Fleming, discovery of penicillin. And here you can see the figure here. This is the bacterial lawn grown in the petri plate, and these black spots are showing the fungi. This fungi is producing antibiotic here, and the area where the antibiotic is spreaded It killed the bacterial growth and it is seen in the form of clear area. Anti means against and bios means life. Anti is a Greek word that means against and bio means life. Together they means against the life in the context of disease causing organism. Specially antibiotic word is used in context of disease causing organisms, whereas with reference to human beings they are pro life and not against. It means it will not harm the human life, although its use causes different types of side effects. It is discovered by Alexander Fleming while working on Staphylococci bacteria. Actually, Alexander Fleming was working on Staphylococci bacteria and once observed a mold growing in one of his unwashed culture plate around which Staphylococci could not grow. So he was the discoverer of antibiotics. He found out that it was due to a chemical produced by a mold and he named it penicillin after the mold Penicillium notatum. So this is the fungi, or you can say source of the first antibiotic Penicillium notatum. Its full potential as an effective antibiotic was established by Ernest Chain and Howard Florey. So, in the year 1945, Alexander Fleming, Ernest Chain and Howard Florey was awarded by Nobel Prize. It is used to treat bacterial diseases like plague, cholera, leprosy and many other diseases. The third use of microbes in the industry for the formation of different types of chemicals, for the formation of different types of enzymes and other bioactive molecules. So, dear students, in the very first one, chemicals, we can prepare the citric acid, acetic acid, butyric acid, lactic acid and ethanol with the help of different types of microbes. Just like, have an example, Aspergillus niger. It is a fungi that helps in the production of citric acid. Acetobacter acetae, it is a bacteria that helps in the production of acetic acid. Clostridium botulinum, botulicum, this bacteria is helpful in the production of butyric acid. Lactobacillus, it helps in the production of lactic acid. And yeast, Saccharomyces cerevisiae, is used for commercial production of ethanol. So these are the important chemicals which were prepared in the laboratory and industries with the help of microbes. Second is enzymes. Different types of enzymes are useful in the industries and medicinal purpose. So enzymes like lipases are used in detergent formulations and are helpful in removing oily stains from the laundry. So it is used in Surf Excel powder. You can see, if you are preparing the mango juice at home and if you are buying the mango slice, then what will you see? The bottle juices are clarified in comparison of the mango juice prepared at home. What is the reason behind this? The bottle juices are clarified by the use of pectinases and proteases. These enzymes help in the clarification of bottle juices. The most important, in the past 2 years, question is asked on this enzyme streptokinase. It is produced by Streptococcus and modified by genetic engineering. And it is used as a clot buster for removing clots from blood vessels of patients who have undergone myocardial infarction leading to heart attacks. So many times you can see, if any person is suffering from heart attack, then doctor uses a costly injection. That was the injection is streptokinase. So streptokinase is the enzyme that will help in the clot buster in the heart attack cases. The third These are the bioactive chemicals or biochemicals, cyclosporine. Cyclosporine A, that is used as an immunosuppressive agent. It is basically immunosuppressive agent in organ transplant patients, is produced by fungi Trichoderma polysporum. So Trichoderma polysporum is a fungi that is producing cyclosporine A, and it is used at the time of organ transplant because it is immunosuppressive in nature. What is the statin? Statins produced by yeast Monascus purpureus have been commercialized as blood cholesterol lowering agents. Basically, it lowers down the blood cholesterol and it acts by competitively inhibiting the enzyme responsible for synthesis of cholesterol. So if any person is suffering from high cholesterol level, then doctor will give statins to him so that he can be recovered. So in the part first, today we have discussed about the usage of microbes in household and industries. We have discussed about the curd. How can we prepare the curd? By using the lactic acid bacteria. How can we prepare the idli, dosa and bakery products? By using the microbes and toddy also. This is used in the southern part of the India. It is a traditional alcoholic drink where we also use the microbes for the fermentation. On the other hand, in the industrial purpose, fermented beverages like whiskey, brandy, rum, wine and beer, we have already discussed about this. Antibiotics, the first antibiotic was discovered by Alexander Fleming. Antibiotic is a biochemical released from microbes that helps for the killing of bacteria or to stop the growth of the bacteria. This is basically antibacterial only. And bioactive substances, we have used streptokinase in case of heart attacks and statins in case of high cholesterol level. So dear students, in the part first we have finished all these topics. Just try to understand and learn these topics. If you have any problem, you may ask your queries to me. Thank you. Have a nice day.